What's up? Meritei here, and in this video, we will be covering the superficial muscles of the back. Generally, the muscles of the back consist of the superficial muscles and the deep muscles, so let's take a closer look at the superficial muscles. These muscles are divided into layers, so the first layer is the most superficial one. It consists of the trapezius, as you see here, and the latissimus dorsi. The second layer are the rhomboid major, rhomboid minor, and the levator scapula. And the third layer of muscles consists of the serratus posterior superior and the serratus posterior inferior. So these are the muscles we're going to go through throughout this video, and we will start with the first layer, the trapezius. Now the trapezius is this large muscle that take up the majority of your shoulders. They can also be classified as the craniothoracal muscles, in addition to being one of the superficial muscles of the back. Now the trapezius consists of three parts. There's a superior part, a middle part, and an inferior part. The superior part will originate from the superior nuchal line, the external occipital protuberance, and the nuchal ligaments. It's then going to insert at the acromial end of the clavicle, as you see here, as well as the acromium of the scapula. Then we have the middle part, which originates from the spinous processes of C7 to T3 or T4, and is going to insert at the spine of the scapula, as you see here, as well as the acromium. Then we have the inferior part, which originates from the spinous processes of T4 to T12 and inserts at the spine of the scapula, as you see here. So what's the function of the trapezius? The inferior part will pull the shoulders downwards, middle and the superior fibers will pull the scapula towards the midline, as well as elevating the scapula. They may also extend the head to the side as well in strong contractions, but primarily they're associated with movement of the scapula. So that is the trapezius. Next we have the latissimus dorsi, and the latissimus dorsi has several origin points, so let's go through them one by one. It's first going to originate from the spinous processes of T7 to T12. It's also going to originate from the thoracolumbar fascia and from the iliac crest, and from the inferior surface of the 9th to 12th rib, and the inferior angle of the scapula. The fibers are then going to go from all of these places and unite and insert at the crest of the lesser tubercle on the humerus, as you see here. The overall function of the latissimus dorsi is to internally rotate, adduct, and dorsal flex the arm. So that was the first layer of the superficial muscles of the back. Then, if you remove the trapezius and the latissimus dorsi, you will get to the second layer, which consists of the rhomboid major, as you see here. This muscle originates from the spinous processes of T1 to T4 and inserts at the lower two-thirds of the medial border of the scapula. Its function is to elevate and retract the scapula, as well as internal rotation of the scapula. Then we have the rhomboid minor, which is this one. It originates from the spinous process of C6 to C7 and inserts at the upper one-third of the medial border of the scapula, so it's located superior to the rhomboid major, and its function is more or less the same, which is elevation and retraction of the scapula, as well as internal rotation of the scapula. Then there is the levator scapula, this one. It originates from the spinous processes of C1 to C6 and inserts at the superior angle of the scapula. Its function is to elevate the scapula. And that was the second layer of the superficial muscles of the back. Now, if you remove these three muscles, we will get to the third and the last layer, which consists of the serratus muscles. First, we have the serratus posterior superior, which is here, underneath the rhomboids. It originates from the spinous processes of C6 to T2 and inserts at the external surface of the 2nd to the 5th rib. Its function is to elevate the ribs to help with inspiration by expanding the thoracic cavity so that air can come in. The other muscle is the serratus posterior inferior, which is down here. It originates from the spinous processes of T11 to L2 and inserts at the external surface of the 9th to 12th ribs, and its function is the opposite of the serratus posterior superior. This one is going to pull the ribs down to aid with the process of expiration, breathing out, basically. And that was the third layer of the superficial back muscles. In the next video, we will go through the classification system and all the muscles that are considered a part of the deep back muscles.